Now, here's an example of a page with open graph meta tags. For example, if I want to share this page on social media, such as Facebook, if I want to share the URL here, you can see that it is fetching the featured image, the site URL, the meta title, and the meta description of the page. The same goes for X. If I were to paste the same URL here, you can see that it fetches the featured image, the site URL, and the meta title. Now, what if a page does not have open graph meta tags? When you share a link on Facebook, it would just be a simple text link. It would not fetch the image, meta title, and description. The same goes for X. If we share the link, it will not have the nice Twitter card as we have seen. So if you want your followers, supporters, or fellow bloggers to share a nice social media post for your page that increases the click-through rate, then you want to learn how to add open graph meta tags to your pages. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one tool that provides easy-to-use SEO and AI tools, and this channel provides you with tips, tricks, and tutorials to help you grow your search traffic. So if you're new to us, consider subscribing. Anyway, what exactly are open graph meta tags and what do they look like? Just as schema markups help search engines understand the content of a page, which we have talked about in these videos, links in the description, open graph meta tags help social media platforms like Facebook, X, and other social networks read and understand your page and also display it richly on their platforms. The meta tags should be added on every page of your website because you never know when or where someone is going to share your page on social platforms. For example, on this blog post, if I right-click and select View Page Source, this entire section here are all open graph meta tags for the page. OG here stands for Open Graph, and each tag has a property that defines what the type of information you're providing, and a content attribute, which is the actual information of the tag. For example, this meta property defines that this meta tag is an open graph title, and the open graph title should be filled with this content. This meta tag is an open graph description, and this is the actual description. The same goes for the rest. It starts with the type of tag and the actual content of the tag. Now, all open graph meta tags have to be added within the head section of the page. So as you can see, this is the start of the head tag, and these are all the open graph meta tags, and they are embedded within the head tag of the page, as you can see. So this is the start of the head tag, the content of the head tag, and the close of the head tag. And by now, you must be wondering, how should you add these set of codes to your website, right? To be honest, if you use RankMath, the open graph meta tags are applied to your pages automatically, and we will talk about how to customize them in a while. But if you don't use RankMath, let me share with you how to add open graph meta tags to your pages. Now, before we talk about adding the meta tags without a plugin, we must know that most of the open graph meta tags are good to have. They are optional. But there are certain tags that are essential for every page, such as the OG title tag, the OG type, OG URL, OG description, and the OG image. So for the sake of demonstration, I will only share with you how to add the important meta tags. So if you want to add open graph meta tags to all your posts or pages, you will need to add it to the head section of your site. To do that, hover over Appearance, and for most themes, you'll be able to access the theme file editor. Then in the theme files on the right, select the theme header or the header.php. Now the open graph meta tags need to be added within the head section. As you can see, this is the start of the head section, and this is the end of the head section. So right above the close of the head section, that's where we will add our codes. Let's start with the post or page title. We will need to start with the PHP, and then hit enter or return to give it some space, and add this set of code, which checks if a page is a single post or page, and if it is true, then the open graph title will adopt the title of the page. If not, the open graph title will be the name of the site. Then right after this set of code, you need to close off the PHP. So this lines of code is a function, and it will not be displayed in the source code of the page. And since you have defined the open graph title, now you have to add the meta tag right outside the PHP function, like this, which defines that this meta tag is an open graph title, and the content of the open graph title should dynamically be fetched from the page. So whatever page you are on, the open graph title will adopt the title of the page. That's what this line of code means. Now before we save this file, let me share with you the before and after state of applying the meta tags. Let's reduce this screen, let's check out this page, view its page source, and as you can see, there is no meta tags applied. And now if I save changes to the header.php file, and let's refresh the page source, we will see the Open Graph title tag added. Alright, you see how it works. So let's expand this page, and I'll go faster. So in the same PHP function, as you can see, this is the start of the function and this is the end of the function. If you want to add more functions to it, let's give it some space and paste this set of code. So as you can see, if you want to get the meta description from each page, we have to add these functions before we can add the meta tags. The same goes for the featured image URL and the page URL. And now let's add the meta tags. Right below the Open Graph title tag, let's paste the rest of the Open Graph meta tags here. The Open Graph type is a fixed value, which is website, while the rest depends on the page itself. They are dynamic values. If we save changes, let's check out the page again. Let's refresh the page, and now we can see the important Open Graph meta tags added. Now this is not aligned properly because we haven't given it enough space. Let's update the file again, refresh it, and here we go. Now if you want to copy this set of codes, we have left a link in the description. Do check that out. And now check it out. Earlier when we add the same page to Facebook, it was just a link. And when we have added the Open Graph meta tags, let's try it again. And now you will see this. These are everything that we have added. So every new meta tag you add to the page requires you to define the variable, which is the meta property. And then you need to add a line of code to fetch the page information dynamically before you add those values to the meta tags. I don't know about you, but it is rather tedious if you do it without a plugin. And imagine having to add all these Open Graph meta tags to every single page will require you to do lots of coding. Let me know if this is you. You're worried that having too many plugins on your site may bloat or slow down your website, and that's why you're avoiding adding plugins. But did you know that if you install RankMath, just one plugin on your site, you can literally remove single-use plugins like Schema, XML Sitemap, Redirections, 404 Monitor, Breadcrumbs, Analytics, and many others. It covers more than 90% of your SEO needs. I digress. Now, let's talk about the Open Graph meta tags that RankMath adds for you automatically. Alright, let me use a site that has the RankMath plugin installed. Let's check out the source code for this page. The first we see is the Open Graph local meta tag, which specifies the language of your page. This is incredibly important for international businesses or multilingual websites. If you want to change the language here, then all you need to do is to hover over Settings and General, then over at the site language. Currently, it is US English. If we check out the Open Graph meta tag, it reflects the same. If we change the site language to, for example, German and save changes, when we refresh the page source, we will see that the Open Graph local tag has changed. Now, that's for the site-wide settings. What if there are specific pages you wish to change the language meta tag? If that is the case, you will want to add this filter to a rankmath.php file. To add the filter, it is a little technical, so we recommend that you check out this page that will guide you on how to do that. This is the link, we have left the link in the description as well. Anyway, that's the local Open Graph tag. We have talked about the type, title, description, and the URL. Now let's talk about the site name. As you can see, the site name defined here is Smokehouse. RankMath will first take the information from RankMath's titles and meta. Under the local SEO tab, this is where the information is taken. Now, if you haven't added anything to this field, RankMath will instead use the information from your site settings, general, and whatever you have added to the site title field. Now, as for the article publisher and the article author meta tag, the publisher would typically be the Facebook page URL of your site. For example, if RankMath were to publish an article, it will be RankMath's Facebook page URL. And the author will be the person who wrote the article. In RankMath's case, it will be Banu's Facebook page URL. These Open Graph meta tags will take information from RankMath's titles and meta, and then social meta. You will see the Facebook page URL of your site and the Facebook authorship, which is the author of the page. Next, if you have added a tag on a page, when you visit the page and view its page source, you will see the Open Graph article tag. And if you add more tags, for example, let's add smoker, let's update this page. As we refresh the page source, we will see an additional Open Graph article tag added. This is seamless. Now this article tag section is the same as the category you have assigned the page, and you can only have one article section tag on the page. But what if you have assigned multiple categories to this page? If that is the case, RankMath will use the primary category to be added to the article section tag. Now the function of this open graph updated time tag and the article modified time tag are the same. They are used to inform when the page was last updated. The only difference between these two is that the article modified time will only appear if you have added the article schema to the page, which you can find in the third icon of the RankMath tab, right here. And if this is added to the page, there is one more open graph meta tag that is added, which is the article publish time. Without the article schema, these two meta tags will not be here. Alright, that's for the article related open graph meta tags. Let's talk about the tags for images. The open graph image tags are meant for featured image you have added to the page. Now we have already talked about the open graph image tag, which fetches the featured image of your page and plays nicely on social platforms. But what about this OG image secure URL? This tag is used to specify the HTTPS version of the image URL. It is as simple as that. As for the image width and height tags, this will depend on the dimensions of your featured image. It is recommended to have a width of 1200 pixels and a height of 630 pixels. And then the open graph image alt tag. This is basically the image alt tags. It will take the information of the alt tags that describes what the image is about. And finally, the image type, which is the image format of your featured image. For this case, it is a JPEG, but if your image is in the PNG format, then you will see PNG here. Now for these video tags right here, they will only be applied when you have embedded a video on a page and the schema module on RankMath is activated. To check if the module is activated, hover over RankMath SEO, go to its dashboard, and make sure that the schema structured data module is toggled on. One more thing, go to titles and meta, and post. You want to make sure that the auto detect video option is turned on. Now check this out. This page does not have an embedded video and the open graph video tags are not available. But if I were to embed a video right here, if we update the page, refresh the page source, and you will see the video tags here. This is the URL of the video and this is for the duration of the video. RankMath will automatically capture the video's duration in seconds. And if we add more than one video, let's say that we embed another video here, update the page, refresh the page source, and now you will see this is the video tags for the first video, and this is the video tags for the second video. Simple and easy. As you can see here, Twitter or X has its own set of open graph tags that are similar to the ones used by Facebook. These tags give you more control over how your page is displayed on X. To configure Twitter tags, on your WordPress editor, visit RankMath's tab and click on the social option. You will see Facebook snippet editor here. These are generated with the open graph meta tags information of the page. But if you wish to amend anything like the image, the title or the description, you can add the image here, change the description here, and whatever that is entered here will take precedence. Now what we are focusing on are the Twitter tags. As you can see, by default, this option to use the same information from Facebook is selected. But if you wish to amend the details, you can toggle this off and more options will appear. Now I'll explain this card type in a while, but the title field here gives information to the Twitter title tag. As you can see, this is the same information as the one over here. And then the Twitter description tag will take information from this field. And this will be the image you have added here. The rest of the Twitter tags here are self-explanatory. Now there are a couple more Twitter tags you can add. If you go to RankMath SEO, titles and meta, and the social meta, scroll to the bottom and you can add your Twitter handle here. This will populate the Twitter creator tag. As you save changes and you refresh the page source, you will see two additional Twitter tags added. Alright, now let's talk about the Twitter card type. Unlike Facebook, Twitter allows many different types of content sharing. If it is a standard web page, you will either use the summary card with large image or the summary card option. The summary card with large image option will produce a result like this, which is what we usually aim for, while the summary card option will make your Twitter post look like this. It is your preference. Now as for the app card option, this is meant for Twitter posts that link directly to Apple App Store or Google Play. If you want more information on the app card, you can click on this link. If you are using this card type, all you have to do is to add the relevant information to these fields. It is pretty straightforward for someone who is promoting an app. Now, as for the player card type, it is rare that you will use this. It is for video clips and audio streams, and it needs to be submitted for approval before they can be used. If you want to find out more about it, you can click on this link. If you have embedded videos on your page, you will see these YAOVS tags. These tags will help Yandex understand the content of the embedded videos. The upload date is self-explanatory, but the allow embed tag lets Yandex know that the embedded video can be shown on Yandex search results page. Now, another benefit for being a RankMath Pro user is that if you run a WooCommerce store and you have created a product page and you have added all the necessary details about your product, if you visit the page source, you will find the open graph meta tags like the price amount, currency, and availability. The same information is added to the Twitter tags as well. So now that you know RankMath automatically adds all relevant open graph meta tags for you, there is one thing you need to do, which is to set the default open graph image for your site. Now, if you have created a page on RankMath's social tab and Twitter, let's say that you haven't added any image on the snippet editor, the next place RankMath will check is if you have added a featured image right here in your page settings. If you have not added a featured image, then RankMath will use the first image that is added to the page. But if you haven't added any image on the page, the last resort will be the default open graph image, which you'll be setting up right now. Let's go back to the dashboard, hover over RankMath SEO, select titles and meta, under the global meta, look for the open graph thumbnail, and you want to add an appropriate thumbnail, possibly your site logo with 1200 pixels in width and 630 pixels in height, so that when someone shares a page on your site that does not have any images, this image here will be used instead. Now, if you have set your homepage as one of the pages you have created, such as on the settings and the reading settings, you have set a static page as your homepage. If you want to set the open graph image for your homepage, you will just need to visit the WordPress editor of the page and set the featured image, and that's all. But what if your homepage is set to display your latest post? Such as in this case, this shows the latest post. And if you check the page source, you can find all the open graph meta tags here, but you can't find the OG image. Don't worry, RankMath has your back. Go back to your WordPress backend, visit RankMath's titles and meta. Under the homepage settings, right at the bottom, you can add the open graph image here. And as you save changes, let's go to the homepage again, refresh it, and view its page source. You will now see all the open graph image tags here. I hope you see how seamless and easy it is to add open graph meta tags with RankMath, and if you find it helpful, how about a thumbs up? And if you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment down below and subscribe to us, because we are all about helping you grow your search traffic. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.